Hello friends, I am Dr.Sandeep Bhasin from Carewell Medical Center, and today I'll be talking to you about facelift. You know, with age our face starts sagging, the skin starts sagging down, and we need a procedure to tighten that sagging face, and that we can do by facelift. So let me tell you what are the various methods of doing a facelift. So the method that we use is the cosmetic surgery, is called the facelift surgery. Basically what we do in this is we give an incision just in front of ear, that is going from top and going behind the ear. The whole incision is given. The skin is separated from the deeper muscles and the smooth layer. Then we tighten the smooth layer by giving some sutures on the muscles and the smooth, and we remove the extra skin and we re-suture it so that the entire face is lifted up. The facelift can be full facelift, mini facelift, depending on how much area of the face we want combined, and sometimes facelift is combined with the neck lift also to give better results. The facelift is a surgical method. It is done under anesthesia, usually under general anesthesia. Some people do under local, but we prefer under general anesthesia. There are a few things you must know about this facelift surgery. Number one, it is an invasive procedure. There will be a scar. The scar is not in front of ear, just in front of your ear. The scar is not very prominent. It usually heals well, but still there will be a scar. Just keep in mind. Secondly, because it's a surgical technique, there is a downtime of about 1 to 2 months. That is, there is some swelling, there is some bruising, and sometime we have seen, you know, for short duration, there might be some deviation of angle of mouth. Mouth may look like deviated to one side or another side, and that will take some time to settle down, about 2 months, provided the technique has been done correctly and nerves have not been damaged. Now, very important, the facial nerve, the main nerve for the face, is traveling just behind our smooth layer, just behind our muscles, on the muscles, and it is quite superficial. And if we damage that nerve or any fibers of the nerve, there can be irregularities of the face that can happen. So the technique is very important, how we use the whole technique. But still, even if we don't damage the nerves, sometimes these nerves can get irritated while the surgery, and that is called neuropyrexia, and there might be numbness or change or some temporary, you know, deviation of angle of mouth or some changes in the mouth that will take some time to settle down. So that is something we have to keep in mind, that some irregularity in the face can be there. It may take up to 3 months, 2 months, or even 4 months for the whole thing to settle down. So keep this in mind. Then the bruising and swelling usually take about 3 to 4 weeks to settle down. So post-operatively, after facelift surgery, there is a definite downtime, and you must be mentally prepared for that downtime and be okay with that. But what we have seen in long run, the results of cosmetic facelift are very, very good. People feel very, their look changes by 5 to 10 years. They look much younger, much brighter. And we can combine this facelift with fat grafting, with chemical peels and skin lasers to further improve our results in how you look and how your appearances changes. So with this, there's a very dramatic change in the look that we can get if we combine facelift surgery along with TCA peels or some chemical peels and lasers, fractional lasers, to improve the results that we can get. So this is the thing, that the facelift is the surgical method that we are using. There are non-surgical methods like high intensity focused ultrasound, that is the HIFU, it is there. Thread lifts are there. We are using cork threads also, that can be used. Fillers are there that are used to some extent to cause some facelift. So combination of fillers, threads, you know, HIFU, and sometimes mesobotox also, combination can also be used non-surgically to give you some kind of facelift. I found good results with fat grafting, and if that's another option instead of fillers, we can use fat grafting to give entire face a rejuvenated look. So friends, these are the various methods, surgical and non-surgical, for doing the facelift, and I've told you what you can expect after a surgical facelift and what are the precautions or the things that you should keep in mind after having a surgical facelift. So thank you. I'm Dr. Sandeep Bhasin. We can meet sometime in future. And if you like the talk, you can like us and subscribe our channel. Thank you.